Welcome to the Epever Troubleshooting Series video. Today, we will address the issue of deep discharge caused by prolonged storage of the battery. A deeply discharged battery typically exhibits the following characteristics. Pressing the LCD screen switch on the battery cover does not display any battery information, and unable to charge the device using like a controller. Here, we will start by clarifying that if there is prolonged storage or other specific conditions, this situation might occur. It is not a product quality issue. You can think of it as a hibernating object that needs an external force to awaken it. This video will guide you through the process, ensuring safety and efficiency throughout. Warning: the following procedure involves working with electrical components. Improper handling of the battery, including accidental contact between the positive and negative terminals, can result in serious injury or damage. We strongly recommend that this task be performed by a certified professional or a trained individual. Neither this video nor the company assumes any responsibility for any harm or damages caused by improper use or failure to follow proper safety protocols. Here is a battery that has been deeply discharged. From its casing, we can see that its voltage is 25.6 volts, capacity is 100 amp hours, and energy is 2560 watt hours. We will use it as a sample to show you how to recharge it. Before starting, we need to prepare the following tools: a screwdriver, a wrench, and a DC power supply. Let's begin our exploration. First, remove the 10 fixing screws of the battery cover. And then open the battery cover. To facilitate later operations, we will also remove the LCD display connection cable, the negative terminal cables, and the positive terminal cable. Remove the battery cover. We see that the battery's negative terminal has a C negative and B negative, because B negative is directly connected to the battery cell. To avoid damaging the battery management system circuit board, we should use B negative to charge the battery. So, we remove the following: data acquisition cable, temperature acquisition cable, and B negative. The battery is ready. Before we can recharge it, we need to turn on the DC power supply and set its voltage. Note: make sure the two terminals does not touch each other by accident. This is the battery to be recharged and the DC power supply. Let's turn it on. We are recharging a 25.6 volt, so the DC power supply voltage should also be set to 25.6 volts. Notes: please set the charging voltage of the DC power supply according to the actual nominal voltage of your battery. After setting the voltage of the DC power supply, turn it off. Then connect it to the battery. After confirming that the DC power supply is connected to B negative and there is no risk of a short circuit, turn on the DC power supply to recharge the battery. We can increase the charging current slightly to increase the charging speed. For example, we set it to 6.64 amps. Notes: to ensure the safety of your battery, the charging current must be less than 50% of the actual nominal capacity of your battery, and we recommend using a charging current of about 5 amps. At the same time, because we are using DC power supply to charge directly, there is no battery management system to protect the battery, so for the safety of the battery, we should not keep it in charging state for a long time. During the charging process, please stay away from the device and pay attention to the voltage changes of the DC power supply at any time. Remember, we are now charging a 25.6-volt battery. The DC power supply will not stop charging due to battery voltage recovery. If not stopped in time, it will continue to charge, and there is a high possibility of explosion. When the voltage of the DC power supply returns to 25.6 volts, please turn off the DC power supply immediately. The battery has been recharged successfully at this time. We should charge it in a safer way. Disconnect DC power supply and battery. When disconnecting this, one needs to be really cautious of not letting the positive and negative cables touch each other to prevent short circuit. So how to detect whether the battery can be used normally? Quite simple. Just assemble the batteries in order and see if the battery management system can read the battery data correctly. Press the LCD screen switch. We see that the battery voltage is 25.5 volts. Temperature is 26.5 degrees Celsius. There is 7% power left. This means we can use this battery normally. Remember, battery self-discharge is a natural phenomenon and not a product defect. It will occur if stored for too long or under other specific conditions. To avoid a similar situation from happening again, please charge the battery to 100% immediately using the controller, or to 35% if you need to transport this product again in the short term. Notes: inconsistent voltage between battery cells can also often cause a battery to not work. How to solve this problem? Keep watching for our upcoming video. If you have any questions, please contact us.